Oh, hi there. I'm Ed France. I work for the Santa Barbara Bicycle Coalition. We're a countywide resource and advocacy organization that promotes bicycling for safe transportation and recreation. We're a member organization with 1,300 members, and it's hard to get everybody in one place. So we're here at the TVSB studios, and we're trying to create a TV show. Hopefully, we can get together, discuss issues that affect bicyclists, and share upcoming activities. Now, this is our first show, so please bear with us. And maybe soon we'll have like a cool intro sequence with music and a montage, something like this. Have you heard about open streets? From Ciclovia in Bogota to Sunday Streets in San Francisco or Sikh La Via in LA, open streets is a new thing that's really helping reconnect residents to their public places. With me today is Rachel Wiley from SB Open Streets in Carpinteria. Rachel, thanks.
My pleasure.
What is open streets?
That's a really good question. When I first experienced open streets in Santa Cruz, I had no idea what to expect. And even now, coming down here and helping with the one in Carpinteria, it's still hard to know what it's going on until it's being planned, because each one is so unique to each community. And so that's one of the key points, is that open streets seeks to bring people back into the streets of their community to experience it in a different way.
Cool. What is Carpinteria going to look like on April 1st, the day of Open Streets?
It's gonna look like a whole new downtown. The route of the event spans a whole mile of streets, which are gonna be closed down to cars and opened up to become basically a public park for the day. Cool. There's gonna be yoga classes, workout classes, scavenger hunt for the kids, arts and crafts, and skate park stuff, and all kinds of things, including, gosh, a climbing wall. Who would have thought you could have a climbing wall in the middle of the street?
Nice. So it sounds like a great opportunity for anybody to enjoy the street without needing to worry about traffic or cars. Families can come out, kids can ride,
exactly,
without too much concern about crashes or collisions or anything like that.
Yes, and that's definitely the highlight of making the streets a safe place that's car-free. And really, it brings it back to people-powered movement. So everyone's encouraged to bring their bike, their skateboard, scooter, inline skates, a wagon, stroller, anything
nice
with wheels that you move yourself as a way to get from point A to point B without having to use your car. And really, that's part of the focus, is to bring a awareness back to the idea of having an active lifestyle, where you don't need to necessarily go in your car to get from one place to another throughout the course of the day. You can move yourself and save on, you know, getting out of traffic.
Totally, especially in a place like Carpinteria.
Yes.
That's such a great-sized town. Mm-hmm. So bikeable.
Oh, yeah. Bikeable and walkable. It's a great thing about it.
So for those coming in to CARP on April 1st, mm-hmm, no fooling, what should people expect? Driving in or getting, mm-hmm, in by other means?
So if you're driving in, there's going to be tons of different parking spots for you to choose from, located close to the route, so you can park and come and join the festivities.
Cool.
If you want to bike in, there's plenty of options. Starting in Santa Barbara at 10 a.m., actually, there's going to be a group ride from the Dolphin Fountain,
nice,
all the way down to Carpinteria, straight into the route. So
nice,
if you're in Santa Barbara, come for that.
Roll to CARP.
Yep.
Nice.
And if you're just coming through town and, you know, maybe don't want to participate in the festivities, Linden Avenue is going to be closed. No cars are going to be allowed on there. But you're welcome to park and walk downtown, visit the businesses as you normally would, and hopefully also join in the fun.
Cool, and there'll be plenty of detours and access and parking and whatnot.
Yeah, there's definitely a lot of detours. I mean, the main road of Carpinteria Avenue is going to be clear, so you can move as quickly as you want from point A to point B as long as it's not down Linden. And there will also be managed crossings across the route if you need to access some of the businesses that are within the kind of arm of the loop. So.
Cool. So it'll be accessible. It's also, even if you're not participating, a great sight to see.
Exactly. It's going to be a ton of fun.
Cool. And I don't really know why you wouldn't participate, because why not? The public streets are basically becoming a park for the
day. Exactly. Yep. What's not to love about that?
Cool. Rachel, I really want to appreciate the work that you all are doing with SB Open Streets and Carpinteria this year. I think for a lot of people, getting back out and enjoying being on the street, maybe like they did when they were a kid, and being able to bike and have that sense of freedom, this is one of those events that just puts a smile on people's faces.
I sure hope it will.
Great. And hopefully exposes more people to thinking about using bikes or strolling, roller skates, whatever, walking for transportation. Rachel, thank you so much for joining us. Any last messages?
Yes, one last message. As this day progresses, people are going to get used to being in the streets without having to worry about cars. So at the end of the day and throughout the course of the day, if you're moving through Carpinteria, remember to drive safely.
Cool. Thanks. And I heard you brought a video, so
sure,
let's check it out.
Check it out.
Buddy, I'm Fred Shaw. I'm the mayor here in Carpinteria. Open Streets is coming up April 1st. It's a family-friendly event. We'd love to see you out there. We're going to have all kinds of health booths, and the streets themselves will be open to bicycles, pedestrians, kids on skateboards, adults on skateboards. It should just be a great time. It'll be going down Linden from 9th Street to the beach, from 9th Street to Reynolds, and then the other direction from 8th Street all the way to Main School. It's just going to be a great event. It'd be wonderful if as many of you as you could would show up and show how much fun you can have when the streets are closed to automobile traffic and we can just get out and enjoy them like we used to be able to a lot of years ago.
Hi, I'm Brian Falk. I live here on 8th Street between Elm and Holly. I have a nice front yard here, and I'm not sure what I'm planning on doing, maybe doing a little barbecuing or a little soccer game or some frisbee on the streets. I think this is a great opportunity for everyone to come out and get to know each other a little bit more and spend some time out out in the streets.
Hi, I'm Deborah Herrick. I'm the director of the Carpinteria Boys and Girls Club, and I'm really excited to let you know that we'll be getting involved with the Open Streets Initiative in Carpinteria. I hope to see everyone out there on their bikes and having fun.
I'm here in Carpinteria. I'm a member of HopeNet, which is a suicide prevention group and a Carpinteria Alzheimer's caregiver support group. And this wonderful event is going to be physical wellness, and we're going to have some emphasis on health and wellness and just being wonderful in Carpinteria.
Opening the streets up, having this be a car-free environment that's family-friendly and quiet and tranquil. Bikes and rollerblades and strollers and maybe people playing soccer and playing street hockey, and maybe there's some chalk drawing happening on the sidewalk over here.
If you're in a band that you want to play on the front porch, you want to help us coordinate skateboarding activities, an ice cream social, barbecue in your front yard.
And that means that people can come out and roller skate, throw water balloons, who knows? Anything that the 9th Street people think up, they can do on that day. And it's going to be great. That means no traffic on 9th Street on that day. And you might wish to take advantage of that.
April 1st, no fooling, Carpinteria. It's going to be a great time. But 365 days out of the year, we all have access to one of California's greatest resources, from my view as a coastal resident, the California Coastal Trail. And here with me are two folks who have made made serious contributions to better connecting the California Coastal Trail. Matt Daubertine, alternative transportation manager, County of Santa Barbara.
Thank you. It's nice to be here.
Matthew Roberts, Director of Parks and Recreation for the City of Carpinteria. Thank you all.
Yeah, thanks for having us.
How do you all see the California Coastal Trail as something that South Coast residents can engage with?
Well, I could chime in on that one. You know, the Carpinteria Coast and the Southern Santa Barbara County Coast is so beautiful. And there are so many marine resources and visual resources along that stretch of coastline.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, and it's just a place where people want to walk and bike rather than be in a car where you have to pay attention to where you're going. On a bike or walking, you can meet your neighbors, you come up to folks and get to know them better. So trails really build a community.
Yeah.
I have to say, I've got to tip my hat to Matt Roberts. He's been working on this project for a long, long time. He's been a real champion and a real leader in trying to connect these missing links in the remaining portions of the coastal trail through the southern half of Santa Barbara County. And I just want to say thank you for your
work. Thanks. That's nice.
But, you know, we've also, you know, we've learned about other jurisdictions such as Oregon, where there's a real economic benefit and there's a real business sense to creating these links. These safe places for cyclists, for all users who don't want to be a part of the roadway, to be able to travel through these regions and stay in the hotels and eat in the restaurants and use the local businesses as they're passing through. And so jurisdictions who have really done this work up front are really starting to see the economic impact of their actions.
Yeah, because these trails are for residents, but also people love to come out to the California coast and they love to make use of walking or biking and coming through. Let's learn a little bit more about the California Coastal Trail. We have a video. Let's check it out.
So in terms of the California Coastal Trail, I think it's something that people are more and more getting to know. There are missing links, and those links need to be connected. And I know in certain areas on the south coast of Santa Barbara County, we're looking to try to connect those links between Ventura and Carpinteria, for example, and then all the way out to the university and then up north from here. You know, we do what we can to try to open up access as much as possible to the beach.
And that's something that we as a community are deciding right now. Is this something that we really value? Are we going to take the next step? Are we going to complete the coastal route? Because if we make it safe and accessible to bike, we can be a world-class bicycling city, and that means we'll be a healthy city. More people ride their bike in Santa Barbara County than take the bus. And things like the coastal route are great for tourists, they're great for recreational cyclists, but there's also a very large number of individuals who rely on their bike every day for transportation. There's not a good alternative for them, and they're riding the coast route to Carpinteria. So our bike infrastructure system isn't just to feel good, it's something that people rely on. Well, I'm so glad to have both of you because you're both working on projects on either side of Carpinteria that are part of the California Coastal Trail. So first, Matthew Roberts, you've been working on the Carpinteria Rincon Trail over that would actually connect technically towards Ventura County to the Rincon Beach Park.
That's correct. We have a trail that's been planned for a long time. In fact, it's all through Carpinteria, but this one segment has been a very challenging segment because it's got so many engineering features in it that require a lot of vision, a lot of planning, a lot of permitting, and a lot of funding. But all those four pieces have come together, and we have a project now scheduled to begin in about the year 2020.
And it's funded.
It's funded. That's the big part of the picture there.
Yeah, well, I heard you had a video as well.
We did produce a video, and you know what they say, a video is worth a million words.
A million words. Let's check it out.
Rincon Point is an extraordinary place nestled between the Los Padres National Forest and the Santa Barbara Channel National Marine Sanctuary. This beautiful stretch of California coast is a world-class surfing destination, and the nearby islands are a national park. Transportation projects in this location have always been an engineering challenge. In the late 1800s, horse-drawn vehicles could only travel at low tide between the cities of Ventura and Santa Barbara. In 1910, a modern road, which included a 7,000-foot-long elevated wooden causeway, was built to accommodate automobiles. A narrow paved road replaced this highway in 1925. In the late 1960s, the highway and the railroad were rerouted through the mountain. This modern engineering feat significantly improved rail, automotive, and truck travel, but did not provide a safe or viable alternative for bicyclists and pedestrians, who are some of the 25,000 commuters who currently pass through each day. The trail begins at Rincon Park and continues north for 3/4 of a mile connecting to Carpinteria Avenue. The Rincon Multi-Use Trail finally addresses these previous design omissions by providing safe coastal access to everyone. The trail, made of environmentally sensitive permeable concrete, features a bridge that safely carries bicyclists and pedestrians over the railroad tracks. The Rincon Multi-Use Trail will provide a recreational experience with spectacular views of the Santa Barbara Channel, the offshore islands, migrating whales, and resident bottlenose dolphin. Bicycle commuters will finally have a safe and convenient route, reducing highway traffic congestion and the dangerous illicit use of the railroad tracks as a makeshift path. The beautiful Rincon Multi-Use Trail will be designed in compliance with the Americans with Disabilities Act and accessible to people of all abilities. Finally, the project will fill in a missing link of the Juan Bautista de Anza National Historic Trail and the California Coastal Trail. It's time to support this important public project and provide safe access to this special stretch of the California coast.
Matthew, can I hire you to narrate my videos?
That was my premiere narration too. So
well done.
I'm working on it.
One take, I believe.
Yeah, it was. I think they did a couple outtakes. To be honest, I got to admit it. But
you got a blooper reel as well?
Oh, absolutely.
So this project is no small feat. And I know this has gone through a lot of iterations.
One of the things we worked on is a lot of transportation engineers would have perhaps put the bike trail like a class one path right on the edge of the freeway. And as a parks director, I always look for the visual beauty and trying to get people into the natural experience. So we routed this trail in a way that gets it off the freeway. And it's going to be a very, very profound user experience. That's going to encourage use. That's going to bring more people on it. So it's been a great project. It's not anywhere near done, but it's been so much fun to work on this, and it's been so much fun to meet all the folks who have been enthusiastic to carry it out.
Oh, yeah. I cannot wait to ride something like this, to be able to connect from the bluffs up and over a bridge, over the railroad, to get to see Rincon from that side and kind of bike down towards the queen of the coast. Mm-hmm. And, of course, this will connect to the Fertig pathway that connects Rincon to Muscle Shoals. So you'll be able to fully get between Santa Barbara, Carpinteria to Ventura without hopping on the freeway at all.
Absolutely. And I felt really pretty strongly that once the Muscle Shoals segment was in, this Rincon Trail segment was going to go. Because otherwise, that other segment just sort of leaves you in the middle of nowhere. But like you said earlier, this is going to be really good for tourism. It's going to be really good for the healthy lifestyles of our residents. And it's going to get people to appreciate the ocean and coastal environment more than ever.
Yeah, and I have to appreciate how connected this trail is to the park system, because these trails are functional, but they're also an important part of those recreational resources for our residents.
Oh, absolutely. I'm a parks director that believes that I don't have parks in my community. Rather, I have a community inside my park. So with that philosophy, I move forward.
Nice. Well, thank you. I can't wait for this project to happen, and I can't wait to be able to bike all through CARP on the ocean side. One of the projects that's going to connect the other side is Santa Claus Lane, yep. Streetscape improvements, and also a Class 1 bike path connector or multi-use trail.
That's right. That's right. So this is on the opposite side of Carpinteria, and we've been sort of trailing the Rincon project. This one has not been on the books quite as long, and I got to take a moment just to tip my hat to Matt Roberts. He's been a real champion and a real leader in trying to get all of these projects done as the remaining sort of vital last connectors of the coastal trail that passes through the southern part of our county. And the public's really lucky to have him in his position.
Oh, that's nice. Thanks.
You bet. So there's two projects on the opposite side of Carpinteria, the west side, if you will. There is the Santa Claus Lane Streetscape project and then the Santa Claus Lane Bike Path project. Yeah. It's probably about 2 miles roughly, both projects total. And the Streetscape project is located right along the beach. It's adjacent to that business district.
Yeah.
And it's composed of doing infrastructure improvements for parking, kind of doing formal streetscape improvements, kind of like what the county wrapped up in Summerlin recently.
Oh, yeah.
We're going to add about 100 public spaces for parking to access coastal resources. We're going to get some decent public bathrooms down there for the first time.
Not just a porta potty?
Not just a porta potty. And there's going to be a formal crossing of the railroad that will provide safe passage for the public, as well as for anybody trying to use anything, you know, wheelchair or anything, to be able to get across the railroad tracks. Right now, it's totally non-accessible for ADA, and so we're very excited about that aspect.
Yeah, and that's one of the challenges. Santa Claus Lane is such a cool beach.
Yep.
It's really a locals beach, and it's a great spot to learn to surf or just to go out with the family. But it's interesting that it's kind of disconnected by the city of Carp. Unless you're driving and kind of going through the freeway interchange, you can be just, you know, a half a mile out.
Yep.
And you have to go almost like 2 miles along Via Real, kick out, make the big loop to get to the beach.
And Via Real is no walk in the park. It's a rough road to ride on. It's got
stressful.
High vehicle speeds. It's dusty. It's just not a pleasant place to ride. And so the combination of the streetscape project plus the bike path project, which will be sandwiched between Highway 101 and the railroad tracks, it's going to be a whole different world-class experience.
Yeah, you'll get to overlook the wetland.
Yeah, absolutely. And the other thing that I think is important to realize about these projects is it's a collaboration of so many different agencies and public entities that are coming together to make these things possible. And so you've got the City of Carpinteria, the County of Santa Barbara, the Santa Barbara County Association of Governments, Caltrans, the advocacy groups such as the Santa Barbara Bicycle Coalition, all coming together to try and work on these projects and make them better. We've been involving the local businesses in Carpinteria, including the ones along Santa Claus Lane, making sure that we're getting their needs and their concerns met as we develop these projects.
Yeah, for the average Joe, it's hard to know all the different jurisdictions that come into play. Matt, you work for the County of Santa Barbara, and Matthew, you're with the city. And there's also Caltrans, and then, of course, SBCAG, and who knows what that means, right? But they actually distribute the funds for this county for transportation. And what I appreciated about your all's work is that you do the negotiating, you speak those different languages. So at the end of the day, you can deliver these projects to our residents. And I really want to appreciate you both for your work in helping complete the Coastal Trail and make Santa Barbara County more accessible by bike and alternative modes of transportation.
Yeah, you know, and when they're complete, combined, they're going to be a very profound change to the way we think about transportation in Carpinteria and the South Coast.
Oh, yeah. In fact, you know, cycling, we often think of it as just kind of aggressive and more for the sort of like the bold and the brave. These projects are not just for the roadie, lycra, spandex crowd.
Absolutely. Hey, what do you got against spandex people, man?
You know, Michael, I got nothing but love for my folks in spandex. But also, we got a lot of regular, everyday cyclists. In fact, I think we talked to a few out in Carpinteria.
That is true.
Yeah. Let's take a look.
Porque este es mucho bueno para condición y más rápido del bus, no mucho tráfico. Y yo vine de Santa Bárbara.
You know what? It's the best way to start your day. I recommend anyone who has a short distance that gets sick of pumping on the brake and the gas every couple of feet in traffic to get out of the car and on the bike, and you'll smile a lot more. So I guess rather than make car trips and short distances around town, we thought that we could get to school and get to the beach and get wherever we need to in Carpinteria with a bicycle.
Well, that just about does it for the first episode of SB Bike TV. Thank you for bearing with us, especially our guests.
Thank you.
Matt Daubertine, Matthew
Thank
Roberts,
you. You,
Rachel Wiley. Really appreciate you all coming out. And until the next time.
capture your kindness so true, bringing it home with the things that we do. The trees so green, the sky so blue, I sing for love, you can join in too.
The Santa Barbara Bicycle Coalition works to make bicycling safe and accessible throughout Santa Barbara County. We'd like to appreciate the following sponsors for their support.
It starts with one, then two, then three. It's our own responsibility. What we choose today is who we choose to be.
We would also like to thank our more than 1,300 members who fuel our organization and our movement. To learn more about the topics discussed in this episode, or to find out how you can become a member, check out our website at sbbike.org or look up Santa Barbara Bicycle Coalition on Facebook.